go back to Twitter, see if we can get a better question than how awesome I am. So, at You Said Mike Hunt, he asks, what's your opinion on Zelda Wii U? Oh, so don't laugh yet. Can I get the question out first?
Okay.
And I apologize ahead of time. This was not, we did not tell people what to bring up for topics. At You Said Mike said, what is your opinion on Zelda Wii U having the gender option for Link at the beginning of the game? Ironically enough, in all the time that this like debate has been going on, which has been for years now, and for the several months we've been doing Zelda Inquiries, I don't think this question's ever actually
come up. God, you're waiting for me.
So I'm going to let Darren start, just because he is the one that everyone
represents. Oh, gosh. Okay, yeah, everyone hates me. Josh knows this. I put out an editorial. I forget how many comments the guy was in the thousands.
2,000 plus.
Yeah. I said Zelda Wii U should have, or a future Zelda game, should have a gender-neutral protagonist. I am not opposed to the gender options. I'd love that, too. And I know Josh has an opinion on this. You care to say that, Josh?
Okay, so this question, is it about, is it the gender neutral thing or like choosing gender? What is it?
It's gender options.
He says specifically about options.
I'm like 100% in support of that. And I think my tweets were used in your article, Darren, because I just found the notion that because the whole reason that the gender neutral Link, like even topic came up, was because of that that fan mod that just all it did was removed any reference to Colin Link like my boy or anything like that, and it was kid instead. And like everyone freaked out about it. It was ridiculous.
What upset me the most was like people saying that you're a bad dad. I'm like,
that makes you an awesome dad.
Let's back off of that a bit. Everyone has their own opinions on how to raise kids, right? Like, I have three kids of my own. I'm not going to be editing the game for gender neutrality for my children, because I believe my children should experience the same games I did growing up. So they should experience it the way I did growing up. And if that means that for some reason my daughter can't connect to Link because he's a dude, well then, all right. Mm-hmm. That's just the way it is. From my experience, females don't have a problem with that, but from what I know, at least from the Zelda Informer fan base, we are like 85% male. So a large portion of the people that do play the game are male. And I think you'd argue that the Zelda series on the whole is primarily does cater to men over females. Doesn't mean females don't like the game. So don't hate on me. I know we have tons of female fans, lots of female cosplayers. We have female staff. There's a lot of female fans of the game, but it's massively outweighed by the number of males that are. And that could just be gaming in general. For
Nate, you're digging your own grave deeper.
I don't know. I know I am. But it's one of those that I don't believe that my children should experience a different game than I did just because of what gender they are. And this is why I made that little quip earlier that gender doesn't matter. That's the way I feel. Well, gender doesn't matter. So there can be a gender option. There can be a genderless. At the end of the day, I never played a Zelda game because Link was a dude. It had nothing to do with why I played. So it doesn't matter to me what gender he is. This isn't a game that has deep love stories in it. The closest we got was, Skyward Sword with the high school thing, and then they don't end up being together anyways because one's a goddess. so it's... Spoiler. Sorry if I ruined that for people. So it's one of those things that, it's never really been a big part of Zelda. Zelda's always been about gameplay and then tying story around that gameplay into being about legends and all this deep and rich history and all the stuff that the hero has done in the past.
So
it's got nothing to do with gender. So that's why, to me, if there's a gender option, I have no problem with the gender option because gender to me doesn't matter. If it's genderless, it doesn't matter because I'm probably still going to view it as a male protagonist anyways. So it doesn't matter to me if they include it. Now, I know to a lot of people it does matter. They have deep feelings, either for or against, mostly against, at least at Zelda Informer.
I don't understand the anger. I don't understand how you could be strongly against it, because the way, let me think of this. the way I see it, like, yeah, like, Link's gender has, like, no impact on anything in any of the games. It's like Ganondorf calls him, like, boy or something, like an Ocarina of Time, like, as a, like, as a put-down because he's young. Like, but Link's gender has, like, nothing to do with the actual games. So that's fine. So you can take that argument in two ways. You can say, okay, so there should be a gender option, or no, there shouldn't be because, like, it doesn't matter anyways. But I think, like, if it doesn't matter, I think it should just do... The easiest solution is just do the Pokemon thing. Because I very strongly have the opinion that, like, Link is the player protagonist. Like,
See, the weird thing with Pokemon, and I've seen some people bring this up before. When Pokemon, because Pokemon didn't start out the way. Pokemon, you were a boy. It was just the way it was. And then later Pokemon games, they added, you know, you choose if you're a boy or a girl to start. And Pokemon is one of those weird games because it doesn't really matter. You play for yourself. You're not trying to save the world most of the time. Really, ever. The world's not really in danger. There's always an evil organization, but they're not really owning the world. So you're just trying to become the Pokemon champion. In the earlier games, you're trying to catch them all, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So, like, when they added the gender option at the start, a lot of fans took it as there's two different characters. There's a boy and a girl because it doesn't matter. So there's just a boy and a girl, and you just choose if you want to play as the boy, you choose if you want to play as the girl. And they do that in Mass Effect as well. They are technically two different characters. They're not the same character. Now, everything in the game obviously stays the same. It's the same conversation trees, the same, you know, end results outside of the fact they reference you as a girl or a boy. And I think that's okay. I think the counter argument here for Link is that marketing wise and icon status wise, he's very well established as a guy. Very well established. I have all this merchandise in my house that it is a dude Link.
That's why gender neutral would work.
Because if they do the gender options, it doesn't bother me if they do it. But at the same time, I'm on the side that I don't see the point in putting in the extra effort that's going to be required to have two different dialogues that have different things that depend on which option you choose at the beginning of the game. Seems like extra work for something that ultimately doesn't make a difference to the game.
I would say, like, that it is worth it because, like, just the way that I've always played Zelda games is, like, I always self-insert myself, like, tremendously and stuff. Like, every time I play a Zelda game for the first time, Link is always named Josh. Like, I don't do the jokey name thing unless, like, I'm doing a live stream or something like that. And just, I think, if there is that option, since Link is basically just supposed to be you, like, I think the Pokemon thing works really well. And, like, they just introduced Linkle. Like, have Zelda Wii U, have you at the start of the game... Link and Link will live in the same town. You choose which one of them is the one that gets chosen by the Triforce or whatever the instigating plot thing is going to be.
Yeah, but now you're going to really upset fans because now it's not Link at all. Because Linkle is now established as an individual character that's not Link. So now you're telling characters that now you're going to try to tell the fan base, guess what, Link is an option to not even be the hero anymore.
So you just choose male or female Link.
I say it can go either way. I'd be okay with either because I think Linkle in that case, like I don't, like in Hyrule Warriors, she's more of a specific character because Hyrule Warriors isn't like a proper Zelda game or whatever. But like I think she could work just as well as being, she is your Link to like the game world and is supposed to represent you. Because like all this stuff about, no, Link has to be a dude because he's a specific character. Link has, like, no personality traits or anything that, like, sets him, like, up as an individual thing that can't be changed. Like, everything that people think is, like, that's his personality, that's actually, like, the player putting their own feelings onto him.
The Linkle thing, the reason that usually gets brought up for future games is thanks to IG Anumo himself. He said something about how if people really, really like the character Linkle, there's a chance that, you know, he could try to bring her into the official lore and make her part of the, you know, I don't know if that it'll be part of Zelda U. It might have been too late for that at that point. But part of a future Zelda game. And so there is a potential that she could be brought in. I don't know if they should do that necessarily, but I could see why it would be an option. It would be neat, you know, even if she's not playable, it would be kind of cool if, like, Link did have a sister and Zelda U, and it was Linkle, even though Linkle, I know, is not technically his sister, because Eiji Nomura shot that down, because Errol is the only canon sister that he wants to have, apparently. Even though there's all these different Links, which, I don't know. Eiji Nomura just, he contradicts himself a lot.
I could see Linkle in, like, one of the handheld games. Like, can you imagine Linkle in the art style of A Link Between Worlds? That would be amazing.
I love Linkle.
Yeah. So it's one of those things that I am just fine if there's a gender option, because it doesn't affect how I play the game. I'm fine if it's genderless, and if it's genderless, chances are when you're playing, you're not going to notice, because it's probably still going to be a male Link avatar, most likely, because Link has an iconic look, and it's just not going to ever reference him as a guy, but everyone's going to pretty much know it's a guy.
Well, that's the
So for those that want him not to be a guy, it won't necessarily be a big stretch unless they do something really, really masculine with him in game. Like, you know, like in Twilight Princess, when he sumo wrestles, clearly that's a guy. There's no, like, that was the only genderless fan mod I did not like in what he did was Twilight Princess, because so, you can't, like, pretend that's not a guy. There's no, the pretense is gone. His shirt comes off. Mm-hmm. He sumo wrestles. It's a dude. I'm not saying girls can't sumo wrestle, but girls do not look like that when they sumo wrestle. And so that was the one game I kind of disagreed with. I think he just did that to piss people off, to be honest. But, well, if you read his comments, he's pretty salty about all of his mods now. So I don't think it's about it. It's got nothing to do with his daughter anymore.
Like, that's the thing, is that I just thought at first, like, I thought it was a super cute thing that, like, a dad did for his daughter. Because, like I understand, like, both the argument. Like, it depends on how you want to view it, on whether, like, no, I'd prefer my kids to, like, play the game the same way that I did with, like, a boy Link or whatever. Or I could say, I want my kids to play the game the same way I did, extremely identifying with the character and pretending that I am them. And it's, like, a 16-bit game, so it's, like, Link's a blob of pixels. Like, you can't tell if that's a dude or a girl. So, like, the daughter he did it for, she probably doesn't even know that, like, Link is originally supposed to be a dude.
And that was kind of the counter argument a lot of people I saw put forth was, okay, so you're and it's kind of inferred here, like, you know, I obviously was a guy, I grew up, so everything that I've experienced has been as a guy, and I am a guy that views myself as a guy. I am a man through and through. I don't view myself as any other gender. And so when I was growing up, obviously everything I experienced was through the eyeballs of a man or a boy at the time. And you know, it's, you know, like, when I say I want my kids to experience it, I saw a lot of people say, well, what you're saying is that you're teaching your daughter, in this case for him, and that you can't, that she should only be able to connect to females, that she cannot connect with a male character. And that really, it was a point that I never considered before, because, you know, when I think about my kids playing games, they don't have any problem playing as Mario. They don't have any problem playing as Samus or playing as Link. Like, my daughter likes playing, because she sees me play Zelda all the time. So she, when we play Mario Kart, which she is not very good at, she needs my help getting around the track still. She loves playing as Link, because she knows that, like, I do Zelda Informer as a job. So she knows that I'm always talking Zelda and doing Zelda, and she probably hears me talking right now. So she always, you know, she thinks it's just really cool and that he's a cool character and she wants to be like him. And it's, you know, and yeah, she does refer to him as a him, because I'm always referring to him as a him. And he does, obviously, like, my statues and everything. Like, it's a guy. She knows what a guy looks like. So it's one of those that I never really considered that. Like, I understand that it might be easier, say, for a girl to connect with another girl. Just like it's easier for, you know, bros to be bros. But I also have really close relationships with females and can connect with them and can relate to them. And I can understand the standpoint some people might have with, in terms of why it might be a negative for the daughter, is that what you're kind of saying is,
like,
girls can't connect with guys or can't project themselves into a male character. Like, and there was a point that I'm like, you know, that's kind of a fair argument. There's no
I get that argument point, for or but like at it. The same like, time, like, it's not, I don't think it's that, like, you're not, like, corrupting your daughter or something, or, like, expecting, like, oh, she can't connect. You're not protecting her, like, oh, she can't connect with boys. I need to change this game for her own sake. Like, it's just a cute little gesture that the guy did, and, like, yeah.
Well, yeah. And I think that's why people had Yeah, I guess what I saw, based on what I read, which obviously there was a lot of irrelevant chatter that I'm not going to get into because people could just be dicks. The biggest thing I saw was just that, like, okay. So, like, we're not going to make this big argument that he's a bad dad and, she's, 6 months old or whatever, and by the time she's, like, 6 or 7 and 8 and playing Zelda games, she's probably not even going to notice that the character's genderless, and she'll see art and just assume it's a guy anyways and blah, blah, blah. And that gets back to the point that, why have the genderless option if ultimately she's going to end up realizing it's a guy anyways and probably have it not affect her gameplay experience at all. If she's not, when you're 6, 7, 8, are you really disconnecting from that character you play? It's hard for me because I was a boy. Cause, when I grew up playing the games, I never realized it was calling me a boy, or calling me a kid. It didn't.
Yeah, so you're a guy. So you if someone calls you boy, you're just like, it's like, yeah, that's what's going on. But if a girl's playing the game and they call it a boy, they're probably going to notice that a tiny bit more. It's like, okay, this person's a boy.
And this is a conversation that I feel like I wish we had a female on today. Because it's so hard because all we are is we're just a bunch of guys with opinions, and really we're talking about how females feel or would feel growing up, and it's so hard when we don't we have female staff members, we don't have one with us today, so I feel like it's just so hard because all of our perspectives come from, we're guys, we grew up as guys, we don't have a problem with gender, you think he's an avatar and you're going to connect with him, still being who you are, him being you, but we're all guys, so we're always probably going to connect with him in that way. But it's also weird, too, because I grew up, I played Metroid when I was younger, and it was a huge shock, because obviously the whole game, is basically gender neutral and how it references Samus, the first game anyways. And then you have the big reveal at the end that it's a girl, and, I was shocked, but then I still went on and played Super Metroid. Still went on and played Metroid Prime. I still connected to that character. And maybe it was just because the very first game approached it in a way that made it, easy to connect to because you didn't know it was female till the end. So it was an interesting approach, because the only thing I can think of, when I think of how girls could feel, is how I felt when I was, playing Lara Croft or playing Samus. And to be honest, and this is why I still hold my opinion, that the gender just doesn't matter to me. I connected to those characters the same way I connect to Link. It didn't really matter. The only difference
Lara Croft. Yeah, Samus doesn't have a personality, but until, it's
Other M.
People. This was the thing that on Twitter, whenever this was a whole thing, whenever the article had just come out.
See Samus cosplay zero.
Yeah,
suit,
no,
zero
was people family. Being like, well, if you're gonna make Link gender neutral or a girl, why can't you make Samus a boy? And it's okay, so the first Metroid game, it is 100% just done as a plot twist. It's done to have the game be different, because if you're playing a video game and it's just a person in a mech suit, because of how male driven the game industry was and still kind of is, you just assume it's a dude in the spacesuit. And so then it's surprising whenever at the end of the game, it's like, oh, it's actually a girl in a bikini is inside the spacesuit. Haha. And then I don't know much about Metroid 2, but Super Metroid is 100% homaging the Alien movies with everything that game does story-wise and theming-wise. So, and those are very based on exploring motherhood and femininity and stuff like that. So I don't, the fact that Samus is female is an important part of the Metroid games, but Link being a dude isn't an important part of the Zelda games.
Yeah, I totally agree with that.
And I only disagree on one point there. Yeah, I only disagree on one point, and that's that I don't think Samus' gender actually matters. I've played every Metroid game. I never found the gender to matter outside of how characters referenced her.
Well, the thing is, I don't think my big argument with Samus.
And you might be illustrating your point. You don't connect with Samus. It's part of the reason you don't connect with her, because she's a female.
No, it's because Samus isn't designed to be a player avatar like Link is. So I don't try to even connect with that character. I'm playing as Samus, an established character with a personality.
The first four games, she doesn't really have a personality. She is an avatar. Other M is like the first time she really got heavy personality.
She's not created to be an avatar. She's created to be just a character in a video game, unlike Link.
I mean, even Metroid Prime literally puts you into the mech suit. So, like, it's very
Samus is, like, an established character, like, with her own thoughts and stuff. Like, Super Metroid opens, like, it's her telling the story of, like, this is what happened in the last things. These are, like, my thoughts on it. Like, I felt uneasy leaving the station or whatever it is. So, like, she is, on some level, like, she is supposed to be more of a player avatar. And especially, like, Metroid Prime takes the whole being inside her helmet thing, like, very literally and stuff like that. But I think she's closer to being a fully fleshed out character than Link is, and especially by like Metroid Fusion and Metroid Other M, like those, like by that point she is a fully developed character. Even if she doesn't say much in Metroid Fusion, the characters she talked to like know a lot about her and like reference past events and stuff like that.
That's true. But counter argument is, and it's hard with Zelda because the reason you see a lot more of it with Samus in this case is because Samus is a continuous character. There's just one Samus, and it's the same one in every single game. So every reference to her is all about that singular Samus. So when you hear a reference to a legend or reference to a hero, you know, in a Zelda series, it's not necessarily a reference to the character that's you're portraying right now. It's reference to a prior one, and the heroic deeds that happened then. And so it's a little bit harder since it's not all the same character always being referenced. However, they oftentimes when you enter into a Zelda game, especially post Ocarina of Time, Link is established in the world. He has a backstory. There is a reason he's where he is and why he does what he does. And a lot of it's got nothing to do with you as a player. It has to do everything with, like, as an example, your quest in Ocarina of Time. Great Doka Tree knows a lot about your history, a lot about where you came from.
Yeah, but that history doesn't. Why your Inca career? His gender doesn't come into his history at all. Like the gender doesn't impact his history.
Well, that's kind of my point. Like Josh here is talking about how he just talked about how Samus, you know, gets referenced as having a personality, having a character, and I'd argue that in many games, Link is referenced as having a personality and a character. As an example, in Skyward Sword, I'm told that Link is into Zelda. I don't feel like I'm into Zelda. The game tells me that I'm into Zelda. And it's one of those things where... Yeah, but that's because the game made you feel that way because the character of Link is already into Zelda. They've been established as long-term friends that have this interest for each other. And, like, that's just there's one of many, many examples where, you know, you can argue all the facial expressions and all the stuff. Like, Link does things in games that that's not how I would react to it. But that's how Link reacts to it because Link isn't me. He's his own character. And that gets into the whole avatar versus character. And obviously, the Zelda team itself has gone back and forth on it. You know, in 2014, Eiji Inoue said that Link was basically an avatar. He didn't use the word, but he used the definition of what an avatar is to describe him. That's why he said it was funny when people got mad about what gender he is because it doesn't matter. And then there's been other times in the past when he said that Link is very much his own character and this is what Link believes. That's why I said Eiji Inoue. I used to think Miyamoto was bad, but Miyamoto was only bad about the timeline. Eiji Inoue contradicts himself about everything. It's like, depends on what day it is and what he had to eat that day and how he feels. So it's really hard. Like when he talked about like Majora's Mask 3D being made, you know, just made all these comments about I don't know why I did this or why I did that. I'm like, because your mind changes all the time, and that's fine. That's cool. Everyone's mind changes a lot on a lot of topics. Especially things you've made. You know, there's things I did. I used to, before Zelda Informer, I ran a site called Zelda Domain, and sometimes I go back and reminisce and look at some old archives of it, and I'm like, man, what was I thinking when I did this? Why did I do that? Like, I just, things I don't remember, and I come up with, oh, I must have did it because of this, and really, that probably wasn't why I did it. You know, so I always look at it as, I don't think there is an answer to whether Link is an avatar or a character, because I think it comes down to how the player perceives Link to be. You perceive him to be an avatar, and I'm not going to sit here and tell you you are wrong. You are free to perceive him as you want, and I think that's kind of what Agent Noah was getting at 2014, was that you could perceive him to be whatever you want. It just happens to be that a lot of people perceive him as a character. And now I think what happens with Link, and I think why this whole debate blows up and gets people so mad, is just like Samus, just like Mario, just like Master Chief, they're icons. They are something that have existed for 15, 20, in the case of Zelda, 30 years as one singular thing with, you know, a very defined look, a very defined character, well, at least in terms of how the character is represented. Obviously, game to game, there's differences. Obviously, a lot of the 2D games especially are very, like, nondescript about Link. Although Link Between Worlds actually had a lot of references, but whatever. It's all, like I said, it's all perception on if you think he's an avatar or character. I think some games he is an avatar. I think some games he's not. And that, I think that's a lot to do with the mini Links. There's all these different Links.
Links for days.
So I think a lot of reasons, and this is why some people are actually upset that so far in Zelda U, we have not seen the green tunic, is that Link has a very, very defined look, a very defined iconic status. And changing gender or going genderless challenges a bit of that iconic status. Now, you can argue, like
so Darren, yeah, a female Link can't wear a green tunic. That's kind of where I...
No, it's not just the green tunic. Like, the green tunic is obviously the most obvious standard. Like, if someone's cosplaying, they're going to have a green tunic. That's just the way it is. Unless they're cosplaying the Zelda U Link right now, because we've only seen the blue. Obviously, there's people who have done the Wind Waker pajamas and all stuff. But in general, you know, people might not recognize the Wind Waker pajamas, but they'll recognize you as Link if you're wearing the green hat and the green tunic. Okay, whatever. But it's not just that. If you even look at a lot of the cosplays, outside of the cosplays that gender bend, because there are cosplays that players that purposely gender bend the character, a lot of even the females who cosplay them try to make themselves look like guys. Because that's what Link has been.
And they still look like females.
Because you can't, obviously you can't change who you are.
I just think if you're a girl and you're not recognized as both the Link from Wind Waker and the Link from Twilight Princess, if like, because everyone like gets that those are like the same like look. Yeah, like they're the same symbolism and iconography. Like I don't think it's that big a stretch to have like it's a green like skirt along with the tunic or something and it's a girl. Like
it's all about traditionalism, really. That's really what the argument comes down to, is he's always been a guy. It's been 30 years of him being a guy. As you're like, saying, you know, gender to you really doesn't matter per se, because you're still going to view him as a guy anyways. And it's one of those that, you know, we really need a female perspective on it. And I've seen several females say, oh, I connect with them just fine. Well, that's great. But I would like to hear a female that almost feels like you feel, like gender options should be a thing. I would connect with the character more. Because I think if we can get a perspective of someone who disconnected from the character because of the gender, that would be a very interesting perspective to have. Because we've all connected with Link, but we're all guys. So I would like to find a female. I've seen female commenters say that I haven't actually seen a female commenter say they disconnected. That's why I want to actually, if you're out there, if you're listening to Zelda Inquiries right now, hit me up, email me. I will gladly get you on a future episode, or maybe a separate podcast where we could just talk about the gender, get it all out of the way, and you let me know how you feel. Tell me why the gender matters to you, why you disconnected from the character. I really want to know, because we're really just taking shots in the dark on why we feel we might disconnect from the character if it was the other way around. But we, again, it's shots in the dark. I can't tell you how I would feel, because Link has always been a guy. If Link started out as a female, would I feel different today and was always a female? I have no idea, because that reality does not exist. It's all about traditionalism for a lot of people. They see Link and they're like, look, he's always been a guy. It's been 30 years of him being a guy. There's no reason to change him. The games are still popular and blah, 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 blah. And I understand the big reason to change is to expand the audience. And that's...
Okay.
People have a problem here's, with that idea.
Here's my solution, which I've gone on like the record of saying this is, I think, the ideal way to approach this. Like, I'm also 100% for like gender-neutral Link, or like even having Link himself able to be female. Like, I'm totally okay with those. I wouldn't be mad if Nintendo did that, but I think the ideal way to, like, try and appease everyone is make it, you pick between Link and Linkle at the start of Zelda Wii U. You choose, are you Link or are you Linkle? Okay, you pick one of those, you give them a name, you give your horse a name, bada boom, bada bing. You're, like, I think that's the best way to go about it, because then it's like, oh, Link is, like, in this adventure, Link, like, it was Linkle that did the thing. But Link is still, if you think of him as a specific character and he has to, like, stay that way, Link is still there. You're playing as Linkle.
I've always, we've had, before this genderless stuff came out, because the genderless stuff is what's really got people off the rockers. There's been a lot of debates in the past at Zelda Informer, pretty much since Eiji Nomura suggested that, you know, Link could potentially be female, but it doesn't matter, and ultimately shot it down after he trolled everyone. But whether there should be a gender option, and I've always stood on the side that I don't care. If people care about the gender so much, then put an option in. And if that option ends up being Link versus Linkle or whatever it ends up being, it probably won't be Link versus Linkle. It could still just be Link, with just a female version and a male version, and the differences are very slight between the character models. And then in the game, it might be a genderless text situation. Well,
so they don't have to write the text twice. That, you know, if they did that and didn't announce it, like, let's say the next, like, Zelda Wii U, like, just comes out, it's like what everyone's expecting. It's like, they never, like, say Link's not male or anything, but then just all the text in the game, like, they just never actually refer to you as, like, boy or he. It's like they, like, they did that in Undertale, and I didn't realize until, like, halfway through Undertale that I wasn't, that they were being gender neutral. I just assumed it was, like, a boy because that was just how I was playing the game. And it's like, oh, they never actually say that. I just assumed because I was connecting to the character. And so, like, no one would notice if they did that, yeah. But everyone's making, well, yeah. Like, people make a big fuss, like, at the idea of it.
Well, they because the big fuss with the genderless thing, I think, is obviously in the 2D games, you know, it's pixels and you can't tell, whatever. But you know, in the box art and everything else, it's definitely a guy. So I think the bigger deal with the gender neutral stuff is that if the character depiction is clearly a male, whether it's in pixels, you can't always make it clearly a male, but if the box art for it and all the art surrounding it clearly shows that that's a male, people don't understand why you would even need to go so far as gender neutral. If there's more, things to gender than just being gender, you know, saying that they never reference you as a boy doesn't mean that character's not a boy. I don't even know,
from the little trailer we've gotten.
Yeah, but we haven't seen any of the art for Zelda Wii U.
That one trailer for Zelda Wii U.
And, like, when AJ Enuma said that could be a girl. Yeah, go ahead, Josh.
Well, he remember, he never actually said that it could be a girl. He just didn't say it wasn't a girl.
Yeah.
He just said that's an interesting thought process, and then he laughed. And then people took off with it and said,
but some people believed.
That's not Link, or that's... Because he said, you know, I never said that was explicitly Link. He was just trolling. Like, he was literally trolling. No, he didn't. He probably didn't think it was going to blow up like that.
The thing is
that it was just,
like,
a one-off comment in an interview.
Like, the character model in Zelda Wii U, like, that one trailer we saw, like... I could totally see that as being a girl, just if they didn't, like, reference it. Like, there's nothing about that character design that sticks out to me as, like, oh, that's got to be a dude, other than the fact that Link is traditionally a dude.
Yeah.
Well, that's just so far. Well, that's just so far. Let's be fair. When we talk about Zelda,
I need E3 to get
it's
here.
Like, you haven't even seen the game at this point. We know. We basically know the art style, like the general direction of the art style, and that's pretty much it.
That could even change by the time we see it. It's been the same looking. Like, we haven't seen a trailer in we haven't seen footage in a year and a half. Yeah.
No, we saw footage last November or something like that.
Yeah, there was like a 16-second clip.
Yeah. And it was all new, and it had like new weapons, and it was in a new area. So it is, as far as I'm aware, unless they change art styles this year, which I doubt it, based on Eiji Nomura's comments, that it clearly seems like they're in the final stages heading into E3 here. So to me, I tried to stay away from, you know, the Zelda U, and if that Link, I mean, for all we know, there's another part in the game where he has to be shirtless for something. And usually shirtless is one of the big giveaways on is it a guy or is it a girl. And that's like in Twilight Princess, why I thought the gender neutral thing was just so canned, because the game clearly depicts you as a boy with or without the text saying it.
Then just don't make him shirtless in Zelda U.
Well, I know. I'm not saying that, you know, let's just not make him shirtless. I think the shirtless thing wasn't about gender at the time anyways. It was just about the impact of the gameplay of sumo wrestling, and sumo wrestlers traditionally not having shirts on. That was the idea.
Yeah.
So, like, I would hate for Nintendo to be like, man, we have to consider genders when we're considering how we want to approach gameplay and referencing real-world type things in a game. That's why I think
it's not going to have that much of an impact, though.
Like I think, like, to be honest, you know, if they never said anything about it and ends up being gender neutral in the text, no one's really going to notice. I mean, they might notice now because they might be looking for it now. You know, if it doesn't blow over by then, and the more we keep talking about it, the less and less it's going to blow over. But I think that it's one of those that, like, if there was a gender option at the beginning of the game, they didn't even talk about it, and they just released the game and it had it. I think, well, in my opinion, the gender option is obviously the best thing for everyone. I think if they just keep it, it's the same Link.
Yeah.
You could just decide it's female or decide it's male at the beginning of the game, and that's just that. And then it's just kind of an androgynous look, which Link has arguably, I would say, had at times. I have often called Link a pretty boy, which means you can kind of get away with both looks if they just alter it just enough where you can't tell, which, as you referenced, Zelda U Link is kind of altered to that state right now where you couldn't necessarily tell. And that's all fine. That's great. Whatever. That to me would be the best approach. The problem is that all these people that are so against it make up, so far, the very, very, very vocal majority of people talking. Now, there are people that feel the other way, but it's not just that they're drowned out, you know, like you have a really, really small vocal minority. I've done polls on this. I have followed and read all the comments. It is a majority against it. So, like, you talk about pleasing everyone, you're really pleasing the small minority.
The people that are angry about that, like, I think in the grand scheme of things, like, with how wide-ranging, like, Zelda is overall, I think that does turn out being a minority. Because, like, if I told, like, any of my friends that are just, like, casual gamers or something, it's like, oh, you can, Link can be a girl in the new Zelda. They'd probably just be like, cool, that's neat. Like, I don't...
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's true.
Oh,
that's true.
Well,
then you have to,
like,
ask
Zelda's
how many
one
of those,
like,
people
the only
even
franchises
play Zelda
that
anyways.
They would play. Like, I think Zelda's just that big that, like, even people that wouldn't consider themselves gamers are still, like, if they have the console, they'd probably get, like, the new Zelda or something like that. Like, I think the people that would be annoyed or, like, oh, that messes with the timeline or, like, the resurrection or the reincarnation of the hero or whatever, if he's a girl. Like, the people that would actually be mad about that, I think that overall is a vocal minority.
All right, so we're going to do a little bit of a topic switch, because I've been talking about this for a while. And as I got to release this in segments, I don't want to have an hour-long segment on just gender talk. And it'll probably be the most disliked part of the entire conversation. So I'll just end it on this. I will say this, if for some reason a future Zelda game features a genderless Link or features gender options, and you are a person that's going to write off it and
100%.
Never play Zelda again,
if
then I don't think you're playing
you
Zelda
much,
for the right,
like,
reasons to
you,
begin with.
You need a better
personally
place to spend personally. Your time.
As I keep saying, gender has never mattered to me in the game. And you want to project yourself on it, you want to view it as a character. I get it. I get there's all these little intricacies. But every Zelda game, to me, exists on its own plane. And to me, it doesn't matter what the gender is going to end up being, because it's probably going to be a fantastic game anyways. So, like I said, you want to write off the whole series because of it, be my guest, because I'm sure you think Nintendo's being a social justice warrior, PC, or whatever. So we're just going to kind of leave that alone. Don't worry, folks. We're not going to be talking about gender on all of your episodes of Zelda Inquiries and all the time on Zelda Informer. It's only when the topic gets brought up. So you don't want to hear about it, just stop asking
Tweet
about it.
Tweet at freaking clever.
There's
I'll
so many things to talk about Zelda.
Day.
We don't have to just talk about this. It's just... Well, he's got no problem with that.
Hey, you can tweet me too, at RealDurn.
So thank you, Mike Hunt, for... Oh, jeez. You can tweet me at NateJance. I will have a conversation with you.
I think we've said all week.
I've kind of said all my piece here. It matters. The conversation is so silly to me, not just because it matters so little to me, that it frustrates me when people get angry on both sides of the spectrum. Because I just don't think it really matters to making a good Zelda game. So thank you, Mike Hunt, for getting us tons and tons of hate. It was very welcomed. So.